Hello viewers, how are you? Welcome back to Google Class. I'm James here. Today I'm going to discuss with Indian Penal Code. Section 304, subclause part 2, cases only. Okay, we already discussed earlier video class, part 1, part 2. This video class only, part 2 cases, example cases. Okay, how it is suitable. So here, one example, the deceased younger sister of the accused was affectionately brought up by him with the hope of getting her married to a good husband. But she married the husband of her own sister as his second wife, thus bringing dishonor to the family. And the irritated brother gave a lone stab on her person, which unfortunately fell on the vulnerable part of her body, killing her on the spot. The accused brother could not have intended to cause her death. He was convicted under section 304, subclause part 2. Okay, this is one example, this is a situation. Based on the situation, the judge was passed by the order 304 subclause part 2. Okay, this is one remedy. And another case, in a fight between two groups, one group A, B group, another group. One of the accused was armed only with a battery torch, but during the course of the fight, another accused gave him a dagger with which he caused a single stab wound to the deceased. The doctors in this situation, the accused was admitted before the hospital, who is a victim person. Okay, in this situation, doctor opinions was that all the injuries cumulatively caused the death. Okay, after receiving opinion of medical ground, the Supreme Court set aside the sentence of accused under section 304, sorry, under section 302. Set aside the sentence of the accused under section 302 and punished him under section 304 part 2. Which section punished? 304 subclause part 2. Okay. And another example, woman took lift from a driver in his truck, one truck. The driver tried to molester her and she jumped out of the moving truck and was run over by it. The driver accused was convicted under section 304 subclause part 2. Okay. The High Court reduced the sentenced to period already undergone and enhanced the fine of rupees 4000, which if you realized was to be paid to the husband of the deceased. The Supreme Court further observed that the sentence of 2.5 years undergone by the accused was grossly inadequate. However, having regard to the fact that 20 years had lapsed since the occurrence, it only enhanced the fine up to as 10,000. Okay, this is also one of the case law. This is a big case law. I give short illustrations. Okay, it is also very useful to your examination purpose. You just mention it, that's all. And another example, death in custody. If anyone of the accused staying in the jail, what will happen? Okay. A man was arrested on the allegation of the theft, only theft, of a buffalo, okay, and kept in custody, police custody. He was beaten by the sub-inspector and three constables on successive days. The SI beat only one day. The victim succumbed to his injuries. It was held that the accused, including the SI, shared common intention to beat the deceased violently, and they must be attributed with the knowledge that the injuries inflicted were likely to cause death, they were convicted under punished under section 304 part 2 and not 304 part 1, only 304 part 2. And another example, the policeman brought a man to the police station. Okay, the police official kicked him and dashed his head against the wall 3 or 4 times. When his condition became very serious, he was sent to a hospital where he died. Conviction of the accused. Who is the conviction here? Police officers. Accused under section 304 part 2 was held to be proper. Okay. And another example. The deceased was alleged to have been beaten at the police station for extorting confession, as a result of which he died. One of the accused police officer attempted to explain the happening on the false basis. The other accused officer pleaded that he came to a police station in severe condition and collapsed after disclosing his name. This was different from his own statement under section 113.113 of Criminal Procedure Code. There was no grievous injuries on vital organs. He died because of the combined effect of beating and TB affliction of one of the lungs. Conviction of the officer responsible for beating under section 304 of subclass part 2 was held to be proper. Okay. And another one reference example, killing wife. The accused killed his wife, beating her throughout the day. Throughout the day, beating. While he was in a drunken state. Okay, not the point, drunken state. No weapon was used. It was usual with him to do the beating after drinking. Usually nature. The court said that in such circumstance, the intention to kill could not be inferred, but it could be said that he had knowledge that such a severe beating was likely to cause her death. So conviction was altered to one under section 304 subclass part 2. Okay, now it's clear the sentence. Okay students, now I'm closing this session. Enjoy with your subjects, be happy. We'll meet you again next class, next video class. Okay, bye.